Hey, how is it going?
Not that good. I'm too much stressed.
Why?
I'm worried about when and how this pandemic will end. Isn't there any weapon that could finish this war?
Is it vaccine?
Yeah, it's a very effective way to prevent diseases from spreading in a large country like India. But do you know how these vaccines get transported to each and every part of the country? And how these vaccines are produced at a large scale? And what if we do not have proper sewage facilities? Won't all vaccine get wasted?
Yeah, of course. Some vaccines like Moderna need to be kept at a temperature of minus 20 degrees Celsius, while some like Covaxin at 8 degrees Celsius. But Pfizer, it requires a temperature of minus 60 degrees Celsius. So it looks like a big challenge.
Yeah, it's a pretty low temperature. But wait, I remember that I read something like 4 billion vaccines are produced per year, and that too need a different temperature to be stored properly. Oh man, I'm apprehensive if current facilities will suffice the demand. Even if it suffices, will it be effective enough?
Don't worry, brother. Someone has come up with a solution. Let me take you to Group G26. They have designed a device, a thermoelectric vaccine box, which can store vaccine at different temperatures. Let's see what it is.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to our presentation. We are delighted to present to you the project we carried out. The main motivation for this project came from the current situation. We were also worried, like you, about the transportation and storage of vaccines. Do you guys know? Vaccines may get damaged if they are not kept in a suitable environment. So after a detailed study, we found that the following challenges in vaccine storages and transportation arise. First point is, as various new vaccines require different temperature for their storage. Next point is, there was a need to maintain the temperature for a more extended period than usual because many countries import vaccines from other countries. Third point is, the vaccine box is opened several times. That disturbs the environment around vaccines. Fourth point is shortage of storage facility. Fifth point is constant replacement of consumable materials like dry ice and liquid nitrogen. So we have come up with a few ways to solve those problems. We have used Peltier technology, which allows us to alter temperature by just changing the amount of electricity. This device will recool the vaccines after certain intervals of time, increasing the storage time. We have used the tray system in our device to prevent sudden unnecessary changes in the vaccine environment. It is cheap and easy to carry anywhere. Additionally to this, we do not need any kind of chemical or refrigerant. We just need some electric power to make it work.
So let's see the 3D view of our model. This is the zoomed in picture of our model. As you can see, this is the complete box, which consists of three parts. First one is main storage part. Second is the cooling device, and the third, heat sink. The main storage part includes vaccine trays, fins, and the insulating material styrofoam. The components of cooling device includes the Peltier cell, the battery for power, and the copper rod. And the heat sink includes water as a coolant, pipe for smooth coolant flow, and here below we have fans to cool the water tank.
So now let's have a look how does this work. First of all, keep the box empty, switch on the system, set the voltage required to get the desired temperature. The Peltier cell starts developing a temperature difference soon. It will reach the desired temperature you set, say minus 20 degrees Celsius for the Moderna vaccine. Now, heat sink does a job of ejaculating heat faster and maintaining outer temperature. As the outer temperature is maintained, it implies inner temperature is also maintained. As for constant voltage supply, the Peltier cell will have a consistent temperature difference. Now, once the inner temperature is reached minus 20 degrees Celsius, measured through inbuilt thermocouple setup, you are ready to store vaccines in it. What you have to do is that draw out the trays, which you can see here. Then you have to put vaccines we have a storage capacity of about 100 vaccine bottles. Now again, push back the vaccine trays. Check if the system has been properly closed. Once this is done, switch on the automatic mode. Now, as we calculated, there was a change of only about 0.9 degrees Celsius after 1 hour through conduction through walls. The sensor will sense the change and switch off the device for 1.5 hours and again switch it on whenever required. As the change in the temperature will be very, very minimal in such amount of time, it will not affect the vaccine as much. In this way, this device works. Now, when transported, the vaccinator can open the trays and take these vaccines one by one. Once this box empties, it can be reused for the next set of vaccines.
So let's see about the Peltier technology. So Peltier cell is the most critical component of our vaccine box. It creates temperature gradient across it, and on passing current, one side gets hot and the other side gets colder. It flows from the bottom surface to the top surface because there is a temperature gradient. Now let's move on to the other process, which is the heat sink. So to increase the performance of the Peltier cell, cooling the hot side is essential. Therefore, we have used water as a liquid coolant that passes through a channel and ultimately over the hot side of the Peltier cell and cools it to an optimum temperature. Now let's move on to the third process, conduction through walls. So without loss of generality, let's take a control volume around the right wall of the vaccine box. So as the temperature of the box is lower than that of the air, there is the convective heat flux from air to the wall, which slowly increases the box temperature. The same control volume analysis exists for other walls too. Now let's check the calculations which we have done. So the first one is the integral balance approach. So here we have taken the whole vaccine box as the control volume. And for this control volume, there is the inward heat flux from the surroundings to the vaccine box. There is heat generation, which takes place due to the Peltier cell. And there is the heat consumption in the vaccine box. And overall, we know the heat gain equals the heat loss.
So as you could see from the box, that conduction will be mainly through the walls, and convection would be observed around the heat sink, which was used for maintaining the temperature difference. And radiation will be from the surrounding and the box. Now, the question comes, is there any mode which we can neglect to simplify the system? So, on further calculation, we found out that radiation value comes out to be very low as compared to the conduction and convection term. Thus, we could neglect the radiation value in the further calculation.
So now let's see what technical problem are we solving. So now consider a thermoelectric vaccine box setup as shown in the figure. A Peltier cell setup is being used to create a temperature difference that is hotter on one side and colder on the other side. We are required to attain a temperature TC inside the box to keep the object at temperature TC for a specific amount of time. As it is required to maintain the temperature TC, we need to maintain the TH value. A heat sink setup is to be built to increase the heat flow rate from the object. The heat sink setup consists of a conduit with fins in it. A coolant is flown through the conduit to carry out the process of convection to extract the heat from the hotter side of the Peltier cell at a faster rate. Further, to increase heat loss rate from the object, fins have been used at the inner wall of the box. So what are we finding in it? We have to optimize the design for the device using suitable measurement, dimensions, and materials of the parts of the device. That is, choose suitable measurements and materials to attain the target set below. Choose a suitable value of the delta T according to TC. Choose the suitable electric current to produce the temperature difference of 60 degrees Celsius. Increase in temperature of the vaccine area after 1 hour. Flow velocity of the fluid through heat sink. Mass flow rate of the fluid required. So these are some of our approximate estimates which we have made while solving. We have assumed steady state, 1D mode of heat transfer, constant properties throughout, neglecting radiation. Reasons have been given afterwards. Ideal Peltier cell, and no other heat loss and gain. Contact resistances are negligible, assuming water tank system cools the liquid to required temperature. These are the data which we have used for our calculation. You can pause the video and have a look at this. So this is the simplified geometry of what we are going to solve.
So there are two major currents when it comes to the Peltier cell. One is the ICOP, the other one is the IMP. The ICOP is the current at which the coefficient of performance is maximized, and IMP is the current at which the maximum power is given out. We would operate on IQ to cool the contents of the box to the temperature we require, which is minus 20 degrees Celsius. Now moving on, we have to find the temperature at which we have to find the current at which the contents would be maintained at a steady minus 20 temperature. To do that, we find the Q, which is lost out. The first term is Q conduction, which is basically the conduction through the thermocol walls and because of which heat is gained into the system. The other one is when trays are pulled out, there would be convection and conduction due to which the second term comes about. More details should be given in the report. Using that Q, we would find out the current required using an implicit equation. And from that current, we would find the voltage and the power so that we can say at which power the Peltier cell has to operate. Now, moving on to the heat sink part, that we need a heat sink where a fluid is entered, which is a coolant. And in our case, we have taken it to be a water. And fluid enters and leaves the pipe. And to find M0, we solve this equation numerically. We need the temperature with which it exits the pipe, that is given by T out. And we need the velocity of the fluid, which is given by this equation. Now, we also did analysis on the time required to cool the inner environments, which is given by this. And in this case, we operate at I equal to ICOP plus IMP by 2. And this equation is derived from MCP dt by MCP delta T is equal to Q into delta time. Thank you.
Now let us see the temperature profile of our vaccine box that we have modeled it out. In this, you can see this plot, which is showing the cooling system of our box, that there is an inlet and outlet temperature from which the fluid flows and it cools the Peltier cell. So T in is the cooling temperature and T out is the outlet temperature of the liquid. In the next profile, you can see here that we have plotted the conduction of the heat from the inner wall of the box to the outer wall of the box. The TC minus represents the temperature of the inner part of the box that is slightly upper than the TC temperature, and T infinity minus is slightly less than the room temperature. And here the width shows the wall of the box and the temperature profile of the conduction has been shown here. Next, I want to show you the boundary profile of the temperature across the convection part that is cooling our hot surface of the Peltier cell. In this, you can see a clear-cut boundary layer of the temperature profile across the Peltier walls. Now, let us see the open form simulation that has been done for this vaccine box using the Laplacian form as the solver. In this, the outer rectangle that you see is red hot, means it is not actually large temperature. It is actually the room temperature or the outer temperature of the box, and the hole represents the inner wall or the inner temperature of the box. In this profile, you can see that how the heat is flowing from the inner wall to the outer wall through conduction. And in the right side, you can see this plot that how this temperature profile increases and how heat flows from the inner wall to the outer wall of the box. Next, you will see this temperature gradient profiles, where we have clearly shown that how the temperature profile or how the temperature gradient varies across the vaccine box from the inner wall to the outer wall of the box.
So after a detailed study, we came up with a conclusion that current required for maintaining a temperature difference of 50 degrees centigrade was 10.2 ampere. Change in temperature that we observed after a duration of 1 hour will be 0.91 Kelvin. Current required to maintain the temperature difference throughout the day was observed to be 0.138 ampere. So the things we are delivering to ultimate beneficiary are a thermoelectric vaccine box, which we designed, will be relatively easy to use. Also, it can maintain a temperature difference for a longer duration of time. It will be very helpful in cold chain transportation.